Today's videos are brought to you by Ranjan Motors, located at 139 Dutugamana Street, Kahula. Come check them out if you're interested in getting a new or used Ranjan. How's it going, my car dudes? Liam here from the Car Dudes channel. Today, I am proud to present to you all the all-new 2018 Honda CR-V VTEC. So as always, I'm going to give you guys a full and in-depth review of it. I will show you guys the interior and the exterior of the car. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. The trunk. It is power. As you can see, we have the cargo cover right here. And we do have a decent amount of space. The rear seats are 60-40 split. Just pull this lever and that will fold them. Coming under here, we have a full-size spare tire, which is very surprising for 2017. And we got a jack, and we have some storage space off to the side here with some hooks. Dome light. And of course, the cargo cover can be reattached. Not bad at all. Coming to the back seat. I'm about 6'2". I've got plenty of leg room, plenty of headroom. Shoulder room isn't too bad either. We do have a center armrest with two cup holders, as well as two USB ports in there, as well as your AC vents and whatnot. Here is the key fob for the all-new CR-V. Your lock, unlock, and trunk. This car does have smart key access. Right now the car is unlocked. To lock it, touch the ripped pattern on either the driver or passenger side door handle. And to unlock it, just grab the back of the door handle and the car will unlock. It's finished with a pearl white glossy exterior. Features a full black cloth interior. Along with smart key access, this all-new CR-V does have push-button start. All you need to do is make sure you have the key fob somewhere in the vehicle. Put your foot on the brake and press the start button to go. Very nice. Quick rev. Very quiet motor. Full leather-wrapped steering wheel. Very smooth power steering, electrically assisted, with sport grip extensions on the side. This does have a CVT transmission with a backup camera with guidance lines. Here's your parking brake. Right now it is disengaged. To engage it, just pull up. And to disengage it, make sure your foot is on the brake and push down. Alright, so let's go ahead and turn on the automatic headlamps, the front and rear fog lights, the high beams, the hazards, pop the hood. Front driver's window is up, automatic, up and down. and we'll go ahead and check out the exterior. This CR-V has a 1.5-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder producing 190 horsepower and 179 foot-pounds of torque, has a 0-60 time of 8 seconds and a top speed of 125 miles an hour. The Honda CR-V is Honda's compact SUV. CR-V stands for Comfortable Runabout Vehicle. The SUV was launched in 1995 for the 1997 model year. The first generation CR-V remained in production till 2001. The CR-V has been a great success for Honda, and with this new model, it is going to be even more successful. The CR-V is one of the best family SUVs out there, and let's not get started on value for money. This is a reasonable mid-spec CR-V, but even so, it has quite a bit of kit: power tailgate, Apple CarPlay, blind spot monitoring, power folding mirrors, so on, so on. The CR-V competes with SUVs like the Nissan X-Trail, or Rogue as it is called in some places, Mitsubishi Outlander Sport, GMC Terrain, Ford Escape, Jeep Cherokee, and so on. The CR-V is riding on 235/60R 18-inch tires with 6-spoke rims. Coming to the interior, we have power windows, locks and mirrors, manual driver's seat, your backrest height, and your slider is down there. Accelerator and brake, your fuel cap release as well as your hood release, bit of storage, trunk release, storage in the door along with cup holders. The CR-V does have dual zone automatic climate control, the temperature for the driver and passenger up there, fan speed, recirculation off, front and rear defrost. If we click on climate, it'll take us to our climate settings, where we can change the different zones, or if we want to go Lexus style, we can adjust the fan speed through here. AC on and off, so on and so forth. We have push auto, which basically will adjust the fan speed depending on the temperature, and push to sync, which will basically sync the passenger side temperature with the driver's side. It does have the standard Honda sound system. It is playing through Apple CarPlay right now. As you can see, my phone is connected. Definitely sounds good. Earlier that the music was playing through Apple CarPlay. So basically, to get it to work, you do need to connect your phone to a USB port, and the USB port is the USB port with a sort of a smartphone signal on it. Then once you do that, you have to click allow CarPlay from your phone and allow CarPlay from the infotainment system. Then are you free to roam through Apple CarPlay. So as you can see, I've got and now playing music, phone, maps, which obviously doesn't work here, and plus Apple Maps is absolute crap if I'm being honest, so use Google Maps, messages, audiobook, and you can also tell your time, your signal, 4G, and this is a home button to go home. So let's say if I'm in music and I want to go home, just click that. And of course in music you can go through your playlists and whatnot. It's very, very intuitive. It's pretty responsive, you know. It could be better. It's still not too bad. As you can see, it's kind of laggy. I think it's, you know, sort of early stages. That's my assumption, but it's still not too bad. Also here, if I want to place a call, I do that. Just don't want to show my contacts. Oh, just goes to Siri.
With whom would you like to speak?
Nobody. I have no friends. audiobooks, podcasts, so you can listen to Solomondrin's podcast whilst you're on the road. Coming out of Apple CarPlay into the Honda infotainment system, we have navigation, phone, settings, audio, info, and Apple CarPlay here. It's sort of like an Android tablet, if you will. So you have, as you can see, calculator, downloads, gallery. It has a sort of Android-y type theme going to, and you do have shortcut buttons here, so for navigation, audio, telephone, and a home button right there. You can also swipe through the you can swipe between these certain home pages, stuff like that. So yeah, it's pretty responsive. It could be better, like I said, but it's still not too bad. Info, you know, and if you click this is settings, so your brightness, you can make it dimmer or brighter. As far as materials on the dashboard go, everything's very, very soft to the touch and very well built. We do have some nice metals going here, or plastics, but even so, that's still very well built. I love the theme of this sort of fake gunmetal type material going throughout the interior. Also on the vents, the metals are very nice. We have this nice signature slab of like piano wood that goes across the dash. And we also have some very nice stitching on the dash, of course. Coming down here, we do have a power outlet along with a little place to keep your iPhone 6 or 8, because they're practically the same thing, and, and a place for your car keys, two cup holders. In here we have a sliding sort of storage space. Along in there we have an HDMI port, two USB ports, and a power outlet. Opening up this, we have some more storage in there. Up here we have your manual dimming rearview mirror, your dome lights, as well as a conversation mirror, as well as a sunglass container. Headliner is a very nice sort of Alcantara material, and we have your coat hooks. Comfort wise, I've got plenty of leg room, plenty of thigh support. Headroom isn't too bad either, shoulder room pretty good. The seats are very, very comfortable. They're mushy, they're comfortable, they bolster you in very nicely. These seats will be great for long trips. Steering wheel, we have your steering wheel controls, your volume controls. This is to adjust the display here, as you can see. So you can adjust the source from the steering wheel, which is pretty cool. We have pick up the call, decline the call, voice control. That's like fuel range, cruise control, navigation. That's a rest recommendation. Music, telephone, so on, so forth. Over here we have your cruise control controls, we have your turn signals, and actually when you turn the right turn signal on, you can see we have a sort of blind spot mirror camera there, which is pretty cool. And I believe in the US, or for left-hand drive markets, that the same thing happens when you turn the right turn signal on. That would be a camera on this mirror. Just pretty new for 2018. Digital dashboard is very nice. I love the tachometer. It's very cool. It almost gives like a sort of Formula One car type look to it. Digital speedometer, your temperature gauge, and your fuel gauge, and your warning lights all around it, which is pretty cool. This current CR-V does have just 42 kilometers. Alrighty. We'll turn it off. Thank you all so much for watching my review on the all-new 2018 Honda CR-V VTEC. I apologize about the roadside noise. Sri Lankans are just crazy drivers. as always, let me know what you guys think of the review and leave some suggestions of cars I should review in the comment section below. Like I said, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Drive safely till then.